Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting and informative episode of 13-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 13 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. This tutorial is part one in a three-part series. We'll be creating this reactive lower third using shape layers, some expressions, some text animators, and some fancy keyframe animation. This process takes way longer than 7 minutes to complete, so instead of cramming everything into a tutorial you couldn't possibly keep up with, I thought it'd be a great idea to split this up. It's important that you watch all three of these tutorials to really grasp the concepts that we'll be going over. Check out our new 7-Minute AE Tutorial store by following the link in the description below. Give me some help with that YouTube algorithm by giving this video a like. And share this video and my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. If you haven't already done so, please subscribe to my channel and help us grow so that I can continue creating these tutorials for all of you. Click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video and leave me a message in the comments below. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers and is guaranteed to make you a shape layer wizard. The link to that course, to the project file for this entire three-part series, and the preset we created are all in the description below. I've also included a table of contents so you can go back and rewatch sections that you found difficult. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is create a shape layer. So you can right click in this area that's to the left of our timeline, choose new shape layer. Let's rename this shape layer to name bar. Open that up and we can add in another group, and we're going to call this group box. Within box, we're going to add in a rectangle and a fill. I'm going to go ahead and change this fill color, maybe to something like a darker blue or something like that. It doesn't really matter. We're going to add in controls later to change this a lot easier. And at this point, I need to add in some null objects. So let's go to layer, new, null object, command or control D. So that way we have two of those. Let's name this first one lower third control. And the second one, we're going to name animation control. And let's just parent our name bar to the animation control, parent animation control to our lower third control. This first null object is going to control the entire lower third. The second null object is going to be responsible for some of the animation of our lower third. Sum up our rectangle path for a box, put a keyframe for size, and then shift page down twice to go for 20 frames. Put a keyframe there. Then let's go back to our first keyframe and uncheck our size so that way we can adjust our X and Y values independently. And let's make our X value 0. So let's right click this first keyframe, keyframe assistant, easy ease out. And then the second keyframe, we want to do the same, but make this easy ease in. Okay, now let's highlight this first keyframe, open up our graph editor. And you want to pull this handle over as far as you can to the right. Now you may have two handles since it's a size control. If so, pull both of those over as far as you can to the right. Okay, let's go to the second keyframe, go into our animation control and click P, Shift, R. So that way our position and rotation are up. Put keyframes there. Let's change our rotation to 90 degrees. And that's gonna make our box open up like that. And then shift page down 1-2 times. And we want to change our rotation back to 0 and then move our position over to the right. And then we're going to do the same thing to these keyframes that we did to the first two. So highlight those, keyframe assistant, easy ease in, highlight those, keyframe assistant, easy ease out. Let's go to our graph editor and pull those handles like that. So now if we go to our last set of keyframes and just go for maybe 2 or 3 frames, and we're going to put another keyframe for position and then shift page down 1, 2, 3. And we want to pull this position way over to the left. Okay, so again, we're going to right click. Keyframe assistant, easy ease in. Go to this first one, right click, keyframe assistant, easy ease out. Go to our graph editor and pull that handle over. Loop this, hit N. This is the kind of look we're getting. Okay, so at this point, we need to add in some text. And there's a few things about the text that's really important to keep in mind. Command T to bring up our text tool, Jeff Knight. First thing that's really important is this has to be left justified. So if you go to your paragraph tab, make sure this is left justified. Right click on this layer, go to transform, center, anchor point, and layer content. And then we want to go to our line panel and align this in the middle. Now if we hit P on our text layer here, the main value that's of importance is our Y value. You want it to be at 540 because you want it to be right dead in the center of your comp on the Y axis. Shift S for scale. Your scale needs to stay at 100% for this effect to work. You can change the size of your text if you want, but make sure you do it from the character control panel. Now, the thing that's a little obnoxious about that is that, as you can see, your anchor point is going to move. So if you change the size of your character, just go back into here, right click, center anchor point, and then we want to center that up. We also need to add a text animator at this point. So open up our text layer. Let's click our animate button. And for now, we want to add in fill color RGB. Change that color. I'm going to make it black. Change this animator one. We'll call this text color. And then let's bring our text layer over to where this keyframe is. So if we hit our left bracket on our text layer, it brings it over. I'm going to bring it underneath our null objects and highlight both of these layers and make them the same color. And while I'm at it, I'm going to go ahead and change these colors to something else. So I like to name all my layers. I like to color code everything. It just makes life a lot easier. Let's go to this point right here where this keyframe is located. So within our name bar shape layer, highlight contents, click add group, change this to name bar. Now this is really important for this effect to work. Within this group, we need to add one more group, and let's just call this expression. And I'm going to call it that because it's easier to remember. This is where your expression goes. So the whole function of this group is to control the expression that's going to make the box resize itself around your text. And the name bar group is what we're going to use to animate our name bar. And within this expression group, let's add in a rectangle and add in a fill. Nothing really happened, and that's because this name bar, we can't see it because it's behind our box. So I'm going to turn off our text layer, and I'm going to hide this box. Open up our rectangle path, we can see that our size is 100 pixels by 100 pixels. Remember, in shape layers, the size settings are always in pixels, whereas scale is 100, but that's in percentages. The size of the rectangle path is 100 pixels by 100 pixels. Okay, so now we need to move our anchor point over to the left. Since our rectangle path is 100 by 100, let's go to our anchor point, and we just want to change the 0 to negative 50 because it needs to go over half the number of pixels. And as we can see, our anchor point moved, and I'm just going to kind of adjust this, and you can see, and let's go ahead and change the color of this so that we can see it better. Here's our anchor point right here, and see, I moved it a little bit. Type negative 50, it's right there on this corner, which is exactly where we want it. But now it's moved over 50 pixels. So on our position, let's make that negative 50 also. So now if we turn our box back on, we can see they're still on top of one another, but our anchor point for this rectangle path for expression is now over on the left-hand side. And that's very important for this effect to work. So a good rule of thumb, whatever your rectangle path is, if you want to move your anchor point over, move it over half the value, so negative 50, but you also have to adjust your position that same exact value. I've included this expression in the description of the video, so you may want to go there and copy that now. And this expression is going to go within our expression group on the transform properties of this scale. So Alt or Option click on scale and paste it right in there. Dname equals thisComp.layer, and then we have name. Well, we don't have a layer that says name. However, we do have Jeff Knight, and as you can see, we get an error. So let's turn that back on, change the name of this layer to name. So no matter what we change the text to, the layer will always be called name. So see, now our error went away. Okay, so let's move down to where our animation stops. And as you can see, our bar almost fits our name here. And let's uncheck the scale properties of this expression group. So to see, now we can increase our X value. And since our anchor point is over here to the very far left, it's going to expand to the right. And then maybe we can move our name, hit P for position, bring that over and kind of size it the way you want it. You may want this to extend further out. You may want to get it perfectly centered. Once you set this value for scale within the expression group, you don't have to touch it anymore. So I can actually close that up. And now watch, if I change this, I'm going to use my wife's name to Sheila McKnight. As we can see, the bar follows along and it expands itself with the number of characters, keeping the same amount of distance to the left and to the right. So that's a very useful expression, something that's very cool. If we want to open back up that expression, you can actually save this as a preset. Make sure you have scale highlighted, go to animation, save animation preset. You want to go to Documents, Adobe, the version you're using, User Presets. I am using 7-Minute AE Tutorials, and I'm just going to call this Auto _ Resize. Click OK. And then if we go over to our Effects and Presets under Animation Presets, User Presets, 7-Minute, we can see that it's there right now. I highly recommend whenever you get expressions like this that you may use often or that are kind of complicated, you may want to save those as Animation Presets instead of having a document where you copy and paste everything. It's just easier to bring it in from your Effects and Presets panel. This is what we have so far. Clearly, we have to make a few more adjustments. So let's go to this keyframe right here, and we want to open up our transform properties for name bar. So we're done with this expression group. So we can close that up. We don't need it anymore. So let's just uncheck our scale here. So that way we can adjust our X and Y values independently. And we're going to put a keyframe at the beginning for scale and go forward to where this keyframe is. We're going to add in a second scale keyframe. And we want these to match identically. So right click, keyframe assistant, easy ease in, right click, keyframe assistant, easy ease out. And we actually want to make this first value 0, 100. So that way it's 0%. And then as it moves forward, it's going to open out. But we want our animation to be the same. So let's highlight this keyframe, go to our graph editor, just pull that handle over. And again, for size and scale keyframes, sometimes you get two of these handles. If so, just drag them both over all the way. Check this out now. And now we need to make some adjustments so our text only shows up within this. Click on name, go to our effects and presets and type in set matte and just double click. And now let's set our matte to layer 4. As you can see, it defaults to the layer it's on. So take matte from layer 4. So we can see it will only appear within this bar. However, we saw this issue with it showing up over the blue. So I'm going to add in some animation to take care of that. Right here is where we want our text to begin. So if we hit our left bracket on our text layer, it brings it over. And let's just open this back up, open up our text. Remember, we already added in one text animator for our text color. So make sure you have text highlighted, not text color, because otherwise it would add the animator within this group, and we don't want to do that. So click on text, click on animate, and let's add in a position. And let's move our position down. And then open up our range selector. And I've gone over text animators in the last few episodes. If some of this seems unfamiliar, you can go back and watch those episodes. And I go over what all of these settings mean in detail. I'm going to say ramp up, and we're going to increase our ease load to 100%. It looks like it's about halfway animated. That's because our range on offset is negative 100% to 100%. Start at negative 100%, so that way we can't see it. Put a keyframe and go forward 10 frames, and that's shift page down, and just increase this to 100%. And so we have something kind of like this. And now you can do a number of things with this. As of right now, this is animating by character. You can do it by line if you want, so that way the whole line comes up. I think what I'm going to do is by character, but I'm also going to turn on my randomize order. So that way it comes up like that. So now if we watch this playback, we have something that looks kind of like that. It's exactly what we're going for. Okay, so we'll stop at this point. Next time we'll finish off this lower third animation by adding in another text bar that displays a person's title. Every lower third needs a name and a title. So we'll finish that up in the next tutorial. Make sure you check back in. Hope this tutorial helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. Share this video and my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And please, leave me a message in the comments below and let me know what you thought about this episode. Hopefully you learned something new and useful. And don't forget, check out our new 7-Minute AE Tutorials store. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers, and is guaranteed to make you a shape layer wizard. The link to that course, to the project file for this 3-part series, and the preset we created are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.